Hello, this is the RPG Check.
Every night it's the same. I can hardly remember the last time I had a decent night's sleep. Spot? Where could Spot be? He usually comes to see me in the morning.
Welcome to a brand new Let's Play. Let's play the Whispered World. I'll let you look at the tutorial really quick, and then I'm going to check the audio settings, because they keep changing back on me. So, you can move Sadwick by left-clicking location, blah 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 blah. Yeah, you'll see. There's an eye symbol, there's a hand symbol, and there's a speech symbol. Open the drawer and take a look at what's inside, blah blah blah. Okay. We seem to be right on. Developer's commentary keeps coming up. That's for repeat playtime. I'm playing this blind. I've never played this before, so I'm pretty excited to get into it. A lot of people have said they can't stand this character, Sadwick's voice. I actually like it. It reminds me of, well, a cartoon. Not sure exactly which one. I can't put a voice, I can't put a pointer on it. But anyway. We have all this stuff to look at, so we may get to it. This is a game that originally came out in Germany. So, quite some years ago. So, there's a rug. So if you go, if you left click, he moves around. And if you right click, it brings that up. That's that. If you hold down, left click, you have these different options.
This rug reminds me of one of the most basic principles of life. No matter what you have accomplished, no matter how big your paws or how sharp your teeth are, you can still end up being a doormat for a band of circus clowns.
The other symbols his mouth made just to go, hey. Talk to?
Hello? Are you really dead? Or are you just taking a nap? You can't be sure enough with this kind of thing.
Now the speech, the way some of the lines run together with the voice acting is a little distracting. Take rug.
The rug may look fluffy, but I'm not touching it. I don't want to smell like a dead bear when I go into the woods.
Fair enough. Stove?
Our old stove. The handle is broken off. In order to light a fire, it has to be open first. Too bad the handle is broken off.
Well, I was actually trying to talk to it, so...
That's no use. The handle is broken off.
So I've heard. What's this about a handle again? The bear head. Oh, separately. Okay.
This rug reminds me of one of the most basic prints. No matter what, no matter how, you can steal and...
Same, okay.
Or are you just... You can't be sure.
I just want to make sure... Oh! It's still alive? So we can open and close the mouth that way. Interesting. Bear's claw?
I once made a list of the most probable causes of my death. The bear's paw was listed number 212, 217, and 321 to 329.
It only has three claws.
I only gnaw on my own fingernails.
Huh. So we've got it. Hold up. Okay, so if we click that, it's removing it.
I only know I once made a list of them. The bear's paw.
Okay, same, okay. Alright, what else to look at? A hole.
Ah, yes. A broken stovepipe. Quite funny how the mind works. Since the handle broke, I made a fuss about how cold it is, forgetting how I always complained about the smoke before. I guess somebody should blow out the suit. Someone who's taller than I am, and not an asthmatic, and who doesn't fear dying from suit poisoning. Somebody other than me, then.
Guy sure does talk a lot.
If only my arm was longer and thinner, and it had two more elbows, then I could reach in and open the stove from the inside.
Hmm. Laundry.
Marbles, ruffs, small bells. I'd be less embarrassed wearing a potato sack. Our circus costumes are spittle repellent. That's quite important, especially when you play the bigger towns.
Ew.
I can't reach it. That's too bad.
It's one way of getting out of doing your laundry. Who the hell put it up there? Alright, what's this? A torn note.
What was that note again? Ah, yes. I remember now. It's where Ben sketched out how the human cannibal act is supposed to work. It's so unfair. He can even draw better than me. That's supposed to be me. Ben didn't get the fearful expression on my face right, though.
Okay, so I can only click on these singly.
The most important thing is a solid barrel for the cannon. After all, the cannoneer shouldn't be harmed when he blows me sky high. The plug is attached to the mouth of the barrel. It's the only way to get enough pressure to blow me hundreds of yards into the air. Oh boy, how I hate this act. A parachute should provide a safe landing. Then there's nothing to worry about, is there? A small bomb or some gunpowder are sufficient. Just load the cannon and light the fuse. Everything else will turn out fine. Seriously, that's what it says. Everything else will turn out fine. I can't believe this is real.
And at the very least, you'll walk away with a burnt bottom. Oh, arrow, okay. Talk to the note?
Yes?
Did you put that note up here?
Yeah, I wrote down the instructions for your human cannonball act.
My human cannonball act?
Sure. You must be able to do something useful, right? And Grandpa is getting too old for that kind of thing.
Huh. Grandpa.
Ben must have put it up there for a reason. Probably as a reminder that I'm not capable of doing anything right without his help.
There are instructions on what you're supposed to do, so that too. A hat! We can't reach that.
That's Ben's spare hat. He doesn't like to wear it quite as much as he used to. He says it sags too much since I spilled all the starch. Our circus costumes are spittle repellent. That's quite important, especially when you play the bigger towns.
Yes. Take?
I can't reach it. Ben doesn't like me to wear his hats. He says they always sag so pitifully afterwards.
Hmm. Okay. How about some stuff we can reach? Here's a candle.
Ben told me this kind of candle burns indefinitely. I say it's just pretending.
Awesome. Infinite candle. Ever-glowing light.
Small flame of hope. For what noble cause do you fight so courageously? And yet, eventually, finally, terminally, even you will extinguish. Ouch! Oh, damn. This is going to blister. Why do I have to be so clumsy?
Do it again.
Ouch! Why do I...
Okay. Been saving this for almost last. Let's open the drawer. Let's look at the drawer.
It's depressing. I hardly own anything. Everything I have fits into this drawer.
You're depressing.
I have a deal with Ben. He doesn't spit into my drawer anymore, and I refrain from painting his rubber nose black.
I guess this is how we open. Now look.
There's only that stupid note in there. Ben made me write down all my chores. Pure harassment, if you ask me. Oh. Ah, what the heck. I'd better collect the note anyway. Maybe I'll find a fire somewhere.
Yes, we've realized this. All picked up items are stored in the inventory. I was getting to that. Oh, right clicking or using the mouse wheel? I want to look at the empty drawer first.
Empty. Much like everything else I own. I have a deal with Ben. He doesn't... And I refer...
Yeah, okay. New inventory. Okay. Oops.
Ben has given me a lot of tedious chores for today. Why did I even bother to get out of bed?
Ain't no rest for Sadwick to solve this task. Sadwick should better get outside. If you move the cursor to an exit area, it will change into an arrow symbol. Task is to open the door and go outside. Okay.
We're supposed to brush teeth 3 times a day, but no one said whose teeth.
Huh. You brush someone else's teeth.
Haven't I already broken enough?
I rip it up with the claw. Yeah, let's see what his chores are. Oh, wait. Let me look at it for a second. I guess I gotta hold it. So 5 o'clock is get up, 5:30 watch the sunrise, 7 o'clock is feed spot, 7:30 a.m. look for audience, 10 o'clock rehearse the human cannibal act, 12:15 is wash Bruno, 9:30 p.m. is clean up trailer, 7 p.m. Wait a second, we've got 9:30 p.m. and then, wait, is that 4? I think that's 4:30 p.m. Interesting font. 7 p.m. is practice burping alphabet, and 21:30 p.m., which is an interesting mix of military time and 12-hour time, is bedtime. Okay. So, what if we go like this? Hold up. Burn it.
It's tempting, but no thanks. Ben thinks I'm a no good, irresponsible, lazy clown as it is right now.
Oh well.
A dozen poorly assembled boards hanging from 2 loosely attached hinges. They protect me from wild predators, murderers, and all the other dangers in life. Or such is the illusion. Ben? Is that you out there?
Is it me out here? I don't believe him. Sitting in the trailer all day long, asking me if it's me out here. Don't you have chores to tend to?
All right, I'm coming.
Right, actually leave this room.
Sadwick, come here at once. The day's already wasting away.
He's already coming.
Right, another happy day in the colorful world of the circus.
A little sketcher.
What? Don't just lie around like that. What's wrong with you?
What do you think's wrong with him?
Maybe he's sick. The plague. Or food poisoning.
Don't talk such nonsense.
Worm fungus? Blue pox? It could be anything.
He's thirsty, Sadwick. That's what happens if you don't carry out your chores properly.
Spot can take it. He's tough.
You've got a lot to learn. Caterpillars don't grow very old. Not if you treat them like this anyway. You better get used to the idea.
You're just saying that to annoy me.
I'm serious. You better give him something to drink.
Yeah, whatever, Ben. Come on. Let's go, Spot. We'll get you something to drink. And after that, maybe we can finally do something useful.
These guys talk too fast. It's like they're all on speed or something. You found your trusty pet Spot. He's very thirsty, however. Click Spot and hold the left mouse button, then choose the hand icon to pick him up. Spot is now attached to the cursor. Now let click an object on the Spot and interact with it. Give Spot something to drink. Or can we wake up this annoying guy? I just want to look at all this stuff first. So I can't look at this without going that way, in other words, they're telling me. It's a shovel.
That's Grandpa's shovel. He digs for roots and onions with it. Working in a compost heap, I think he stirs the soup with it, too. No, that's not a spoon. Strange. Where did I even get that idea from?
Nah. We got it.
That's Grandpa's shovel working in a car, I think.
Okay. That's in. Okay. Ben. Ben 10.
That's my brother, Ben.
What's
I'll never
brother?
Be able to juggle as good as him. And he keeps telling me that. Over and over again. Not right now. Can I try?
You want to juggle? Ha! You'd drop your nose if it wasn't attached to your face. Juggling is something for men of action, not for brooding types like you.
Now, if you talk to him again, will he say the same thing?
Can I try? The water looks downright cloudy. No, wait. That's just a reflection of my face. I'm not thirsty. At least, not enough to drink this. After all, Grandpa's pantaloons have been washed in it.
Ugh. Pantaloons.
I'll wash my hands later. I've got the feeling I'll get my hands dirty a couple more times today.
Costume.
This costume won't come any cleaner. Can I take some of the laundry?
Why not have a guess?
My guess is no.
Bravo! You guessed right. And now get back to work again.
Back to work? We never started.
Keep your hands off the laundry. You'll only soil them again.
My laundry. But the pantaloons.
These are Grandpa's pantaloons. If the stories are true, they've seen the whole wide world. Have saved his life more than once. And caused a war. Can I take some of the laundry?
Why not have a guess?
My guess is...
Bravo! And now get back to work. Keep your hands off the laundry. You'll only soil them again.
Okay. What about the socks?
I've had to mend Grandpa's socks about 1,000 times.
Holy
but
crap.
He still refuses to do his bed of nails routine in bare feet.
So this is what's snoring, I bet. I thought it was Grandpa.
Can I take some?
Why not have
my guess is...
Bravo! And now get back...
Mm-hmm.
Keep your hand... You'll only...
Bruno. We must look at Bruno.
Bruno sleeps almost all day. He has to drag our trailers through dark forests during the night. I bet he never has nightmares.
Hmm.
On the other hand, maybe this world is his nightmare. Bruno! What a shame. He's asleep. He's the only one in the family who listens to me.
Must be getting spit all over you.
Don't mess with Bruno, unlike you. He's already done his work for today.
Hmm. Grandpa.
Grandpa looks even older than usual today. Not right now. This chair's rocking days are long over.
Hmm. What about this trailer?
Our lunch is already simmering on the stove in Grandpa's trailer. You can tell by the smoking stovepipe and the birds falling down.
Hmm.
Grandpa, can I go into your trailer?
Of course, my boy. You want to take a little petroleum soup, don't you? Who would take offense at that?
Maybe my insides.
Petroleum soup?
That's what Bruno is for.
What's this thing? Oh, it's a trap?
The fire dragon trap is empty once again. Grandpa always uses Nawahi eggs as bait.
Fire dragon trap?
Hey, Grandpa. Do we have some bait for the fire dragon trap?
No, I'm afraid not. I used the last Nawahi eggs for an omelet.
Hmm. Is there a fire dragon coming through here?
The trap is empty, and that's how it should be. Fire dragons are flying sources of fire that tend to spontaneously self-ignite. Needless to say, Spot is crazy about the little blighters.
Oh, so you mean they're tiny little things and they fit inside there? That's interesting. I was thinking an actual dragon. Have I looked at this trailer? Then I'll investigate our pet.
Why should I put lipstick on the pig? My home is rotting.
Huh.
When will I get my own trailer?
Oh, that's a good one. You should be pleased you don't have to share a toothbrush with Grandpa anymore.
Ew. Ugh.
That's what Bruno is for. Spot seems to be a little hungry. Come on, Spot. I want to get out of here. Let's take a look around the autumn forest.
Oh! I got him in cursor. Okay. Have a drink. Oh, that's cute, though.
Alright, Spot. Time to have a drink.
Hmm. Or a bath.
There you go.
Now he rolls. Spot did just learn to transform into a ball. You can switch between ball and normal form by moving the cursor to the upper right corner of your screen. Upon reaching the corner, the Spot menu will open. Transform Spot back by clicking the corresponding icon. By right-clicking, you switch back to normal cursor mode again. Spot will learn a lot more forms during the game. All of them will be selectable in the Spot menu. Switch Spot back to his normal form. Is this it? Okay. So this is the, when you begin the game, this is the part of animation that serves as the kind of logo for the a company logo. I noticed there's some more things for Spot, so that'll be interesting. Here, Grandpa, I have a Spot.
You shouldn't let Spot have too much to drink. He'll get bladder trouble.
Like you, Grandpa?
He already looks rather bloated.
Yeah, like you, Grandpa.
Can you tell me what's wrong with Spot?
I gave him something to drink, like you said.
I hope you didn't give him the water from the laundry tub. Heavens, Sadwick. It's full of starch.
Who cares? Spot seems to be all right. Bruno and Spot get along quite well. Bruno won't eat Spot for dessert, and Spot stopped biting Bruno's toenails.
Huh.
That's what Bruno is for. Spot doesn't need a costume. I once had shown him a cape for the Burning Hoop Act. It ended in a near tragedy. Since then, we've been performing without a tent. In this condition, Spot would make terrific bait. Too bad the trap is much too small for him.
Poor little guy.
That's what Bruno is for.
Okay, so he'll come everywhere with me then.
Unfortunately, Ben is right. Spot really was just thirsty. Come on, Spot. I want to get out of here. Let's take a look around the autumn forest.
Oh, I meant to get in the stove. Oh, we could
put Spot to open doors with this stove.
If we make
the handle has broken off, he used to be really good at it.
If we make him smaller, we can put him through the hole, couldn't we?
That could actually work. Hey, Spot, I need your help. We have to get this thing open. Do you think you can do that? All right, go for it.
Aww. It's the only time you see him happy. Gonna be all dirty. Yeah.
That was none too bad.
All right, casket.
Hey, isn't that Ben's casket? How did it get into the stove?
Ben's casket? I can't see how it would fit in that little thing.
Why should I blow? There's no fire in the stove, just his casket.
So what is this thing? Hold on. I can't seem to get the pouch open. Yeah, I don't know why that's not working. Okay, weird.
Good bit, boys, but now if I could only teach you how to drool in the bin's shoes. Spot doesn't need a costume. I once had shit ended, and since then we've been...
Give me the hat.
Spot doesn't need a funny hat, no matter how often Ben insists. Fetch, Spot. What are you waiting for? Don't you want to protect me?
Fetch.
Fetch, Spot. What are you waiting for? I used to let Spot sleep in the door, but he grew too big. I remember it very well. We needed a crowbar. Spot is not afraid of flames. He's hardly afraid of anything. I think he lacks the imagination. Look at this, Spot. Ben sketched out how the human cannonball act is supposed to work. Do you want to take my place as cannonball by any chance? Not that I'm scared, but you have the better ballistic properties.
I don't think he will.
I hope to teach Spot how to open doors, but he just can't reach the handle.
Maybe I have to be out of the spot thing. Yeah, I can't bring that up. I've already talked to Ben. Did Ben have anything new to say?
Hi, Ben.
Hi, sleepyhead. How often do I have to tell you? Rehearsals start at sunrise.
It's not my fault. I slept very badly last night.
Slept badly? What's that supposed to mean? Not those nightmares again.
They're not ordinary nightmares. They always feel so real. The earthquake, the craggy rocks.
Good heavens, Sadwick. Now pull yourself together. You're a clown, a jester, an entertainer. You're supposed to make people happy, not depressed.
Oh, choices. My nightmares must mean something.
My nightmares must mean something.
Nonsense. Dreams are for losers. The same with your books and your poems.
Whoa.
It's time you got a grip on reality.
Sacrilege.
The serious side of life. Does that ring any bells?
You mean colorful balls and makeup?
Jeez, Sadwick. You're a real pain. You need to wake up and be productive.
Yeah, some clowns telling you about the serious part of life. When's our next performance?
When's our next performance?
Who knows? This stretch of land is just as deserted as all the others we recently passed through. People are leaving the land. They fear the end of the world.
Can't someone else play the clown?
Can't someone else play the clown?
And what do you want to do instead? Lion taming? Just face it, Sadwick. You're not talented enough for the big acts. You can't juggle. You can't throw. You can't even perform your human cannonball act properly.
Cream
I'm
pies?
Just fed up with honking noses and farting sounds. Why can't we provide high-class entertainment instead?
And what would that be?
How about theater?
How about theater?
Theater? Nobody understands those pompous blowhards. Do you know why people love the circus? Because
why?
They don't have to think too hard.
I get it. If somebody is in search of a real knucklehead,
he can come straight to me and...
His search is over.
Hey, wait a second.
Right, the theater idea is off, but...
How about philosophy?
How about philosophy?
What kind of thing?
What could be more entertaining than getting to grips with the very nature of existence?
Right.
Not getting to grips with it? Do you have more of those terrific ideas?
Yeah, I've written a couple poems.
I've written a couple of poems.
Oh, please. Spare me your poems. Believe me, nobody needs your cerebral whining.
I sneak to the mirror in the darkest of night. I stare at my image and just see the clown. The louder he laughs, the harder I fight. Oh, sinister world, full of hardship and frowns.
Well, Sadwick, that's exactly why nobody likes you. If you really must write poems, why not some funny limericks?
Limericks?
There once was a young circus clown who imagined the sky falling down. He imagined so bad that it made him quite sad. On his face, he wore always a frown.
Okay, no poems then. But
I'd like to do something intelligent is all.
I'd like to do something intelligent is all.
Listen. We make good money without producing anything. What could possibly be more intelligent?
You're right. The circus is the only worthwhile form of entertainment.
You're right. The circus is the only worthwhile form of entertainment.
Spare me your sarcasm. Nobody likes that kind of humor. Now, go and practice your burping alphabet.
Okay.
Or the human cannonball act.
Is there anything I can do?
Is there anything I can do?
Don't tell me you forgot your chores again.
What chores?
I even wrote them down for you.
Oh, those. That's not what I meant. I'd like to do something more important with my time. Something meaningful. Not this depressing day-to-day routine.
The sooner you do what you're supposed to, the sooner you can... Hey! Don't you roll your eyes like that, young man. Responsibility. Is still responsibility. Preferably, you start practicing your human cannonball act, or take a good look around the area. Maybe you can find somebody who wants to see our performance.
I'd rather do the latter.
Yep. See ya.
See you.
Yep. See you. And don't forget, keep smiling. You're a clown. Remember?
Now you know all the game's basics. Have fun playing the Whispered World. Okay, guys, it's running a little longer than I wanted to, so thanks for watching. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.